Hi everyone, welcome to another video. So today, Paige, I was thinking about something completely different, so out of my comfort zone. My idea was to have something green on the page, so then I decided to use the purple as a background, and that's me using Distress Oxide Eye Wilted Violet. So I covered the whole page, then I was using some painting again in purple and white, just to have some dots here and there. The stencil that I'm using is not really a stencil, but something that was coming from a toy from my son. Then I was putting some gesso on the top of it, so then I can draw something in the middle of the page. That's me, just spreading the gesso. Of course it's me, whoever can be. I drew the chameleon based on some picture that I got from Pinterest. I will put some links down below. I was using just the picture as a reference, but of course it's not a realistic chameleon. Anyway, I was using three different shades of acrylic paint in green from Panduro acrylic, but any brand is good enough. Unfortunately, I didn't notice that the battery of the cam died, so this is what you missed. I was just using the Stampendous Foliate Texture Cube to do some background stamping here and there, using the same color, the same Distress Oxide color. And then I was starting refine... Oh, wait. Before that, I was forgetting, I was using the Liquitex Matte Medium just on top of the chameleon, so then I decided to use this one so in case I had some mistakes I could erase with a baby wipe. So then I was using I was trying to refine the picture. I was using Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pen in different shade, green shade. So the let me see, May Green is the light color, and the chromium green opaque is the darker color. And I was using also some brown color, Indian red, for the branch. And I was also using green gold, you saw me before on the mouth, but I will use here and there as well. And I'm starting just to put some shadow on it, try to make it kind of more realistic, with more depth. And in the end, in the beginning, I was really scared about the situation, let's say, because it was pretty strange. I was not sure that in the end the result was good, but I have to say I'm really happy with the result. It's cute, more cute than I thought, but you will see in the end. And so here is just me doing some shadow with the Pitt Artist Pen. In the meantime, I want to tell you something. I had really a hell of a morning. My car battery died. In the end, it was my mistake because yesterday I forgot to switch off the light. And so this morning I had this fantastic surprise, but luckily I was able to ask for someone helping me because I have no idea how to solve it. I had the cable available, but I don't know really how to use it. And I think this should be something that they should teach you during the car license, when you study for the car license. I think it will be really valuable, this one, and also kind of changing the tire. I would love to know how to do it this one as well. Anyway, someone helped me, thank God. And I was moving the car, I went to the shop where I bought the car, and they checked everything, but of course nothing, in the end nothing was, everything was working properly. It just was my mistake that I forgot the light on. Anyway, I just spent like 3 hours, no, 2 hours maybe, 2 hours in the shop. Nice. So nice morning. Good job, Maria Luisa. Well done. Confession. This is already my third time, I think, that happens. Again, because I forgot the light on. The first time it was about the air condition. I forgot the air condition without switching on the car. Good. Have you ever had a similar experience? How did you solve it? Just put a comment below. Just let's talk about it. Then back on the drawing. Once in a while I'm using also the black pen. The black pen that I'm using is Black Brush Pen Set by Kelly Creates. It's a set with three different size of pen brush. One is L, M and F. So kind of the smaller one, the bigger one and the medium one. By the way, if you want to reduce the speed of the video and see in more detail what I'm doing, you can reduce the speed by clicking on the right top corner. There are three dots there, and from there there's a menu and you can switch the speed on a lower speed, so then you can see it. But I was keeping this kind of fast, so then the video will not be too long. So, about the rest of the process, I was starting doodling with I put some line with the in the branch with the Indian Red pit brush pen, and then I will later on I will using again the green, the May green and the chromium green opaque, but also the yellow one that is the golden gold, the green gold. And doing some dots here and there. I guess I had some influence about Puntinismo art. That I saw a video recently about that. Wait a minute, how is saying Puntinismo in English? Let me check.
Pointillism.
Wow, I will never say like that. I need some help to say this word. Let me try. Pointillism. Pointillism. Anyway, whatever. So you will see me then play with some dots here and there. I will leave you now with some music on. Yeah, enjoy. I'm back. So I was using the Posca pen to intensify the white in the eye, and then since I was using the Liquitex on top of the chameleon, I saw that the oxide ink was kind of becoming too fuchsia, too bright around the chameleon, so I was using some gesso to remove that part and clean a bit the border, because I was not really so precise in the border, those kind of stuff. I was cleaning my mess. Then I was using the Uniball Signo pen, white pen here and there to highlight a bit, to give more some highlight. And then I saw that something was missing, because I had too much green in the center, all the rest was purple, so something was missing. So I decided to create a border. Here you can see it. I was using just some acrylic paint, green with some white, really like just messy grass all around the border. And I was then using also, in the end I was using all the colors that I was using in the chameleon. So I used the acrylic paints, and then we'll do later on some line here and there, again in the border, with the three green that I was using for the chameleon. Of course, in the middle I was drying everything with my hairbrush. I'm not using an heat gun, I don't have it. I'm just using the hairbrush, I think it's good enough. And in the end, I decided to emphasize a bit more the circle, purple circle that I have in the background. I was using the Sharpie ultra fine point permanent marker in pink color. It's not written exactly the color name. And then I was starting to create my quote of the page. And the quote of this page is, never regret anything that made you smile. Because I was really happy about this chameleon in the end. And so in the beginning was kind of messy, but in the end it turned out really nice and cute. And so I was using just some Sharpie pen and then highlight with the Uniball white pen. I hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it. And you will see some more detailed picture in the end of it. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye.